Welcome, student. Today is the last class of capital gain, and we have discussed about the capital gain. What is capital gain? What is short term capital gain? What is long term capital gain? How these are to be calculated? And what are the exemptions under section 54 of the Income Tax Act regarding the capital gain? So, today I showed three questions on capital gain, and with this we will close this chapter here. And the first question, you look to the first question. Yes, I think you got the question. Question number one, here we have to determine the capital gain of Mr. Arindam. In this question, both short term and long term capital gain are to be ascertained. So, we will ascertain the income from capital gain of Mr. Arindam. Here, these items in number 1, show purchase, it was purchased on 2007-8 and sale proceed was 2 lakh, it is long term. And when it is sold on 31st March 2020. So it is from 2007-8 to this time it is long term. Machinery purchase 2005-6 for rupees 60,000, return down value 45,000, which is sold on 70,000. It is as in the problem, it is purchased on 2005-6, but you have to keep in your mind, under section 50 of the Income Tax Act, if any depreciable asset is to be required to determine the capital gain, in that case, depreciable asset should be taken as short-term capital gain. So here, this machinery, though it is purchased on 2005-6, as it is depreciable, written down value of rupees 45,000 is given, it is sold on 70,000, so it is to be taken as short-term capital gain. You look to the section 50 of the Income Tax Act, it is clearly mentioned, depreciable asset should be taken as short-term capital gain. Next, furniture purchased on 1/5/2019, sold, it is purchased 2000, sold 2006, it is short-term. Machinery purchased on 1/5/2019, it is sold, it is short term. Agricultural land in Guwahati, that is urban agricultural land, passes on 99-2000 for rupees 50,000, sold on 3,20,000, it is long term capital gain. And one residential house passes in 2009-10 of rupees 1 lakh and sold on 3,40,000, it is long term. And during the current financial year, purchased one new residential house of rupees 8 lakh. Now we have to calculate the short term and long term capital gain. So, write down computation of, yes, this is question number 1. Question number 1 solution. Question number 1 solution. Yes, calculation of or computation of, what you can write, computation of capital gain of Mr. Arindam. You can write for the assessment year 2020-21 or for the previous year 2019-20. Yes. Now you make 3 columns of rupee. Yes. And here we write particulars. So first you bring the short term capital gain. Short term capital gain. Now we will determine short term capital gain. Short term capital gain, number one is you bring furniture. Furniture. Purchase on when? 1/5/2019. Yes, how much it was cost price? Sale price, how much first you bring the furniture sale value? Yes, it is. You can write sale value of furniture, how much? 2600. And less, yes, cost of acquisition. And how much capital gain? 600 capital gain. And next you bring machinery. Machinery, there are two machinery. One is serial number 2 and another is serial number 4. First bring the machinery, sale price, serial number 2. How much it is? 70,000 sale price. And sale price of machinery, serial number 4, it is 24,000. Total 94,000. Yes, less cost of acquisition in case of machinery, as these are depreciable value, so cost of acquisition we have to write written down value of machinery. You can say it is, yes, written down value of machinery. These are to be taken at cost of acquisition. So how much it was? First machinery written down value 45,000. Second machinery written down value 20,000. Yes, total it will be 65,000. How much capital gain will be? Here 29,000. Yes, no other short term capital gain here, and others have long term. So now we total the short term. Total short term will be 29,600. It is short term capital gain. Yes. Short term capital gain, how much? That's 29,600. Now you go to the long term capital gain. Yes, we determine the short term, now long term. Long term capital gain. Yes, short term, now we determine the long term capital gain. Long term, first being the residential house. Residential house sale price, sale price, how much? Sale price residential house was 3,40,000. 3,40,000. And cost of acquisition, it is long term, so it should be index cost of acquisition. Index cost of acquisition. How much it is? Cost price was 1,00,000. Yes, and into cost inflation index on purchase. At the time of purchase, cost inflation index was how much? It is given 148. And at the time of sale on 2019-20, cost inflation index was 289. You determine this one. How much will be? It is 1,95,270. You determine with calculation 1,95,270. Yes. How much? Capital gain 1,44,730. 1,44,730. Yes. Whether you passing any new asset, whether this capital gain, long term capital gain of residential house, sale of residential house can be used for any exemption? Yes, it can be used for exemption under section 54. You know, if any capital gain arise from sale of residential house property and it is used before 1 year of date of transfer or after 2 years, if you purchase any residential house property, can be claim exemption in case of construction is 3 years. So an residential house of rupees 8 lakh, is new residential house of rupees 8 lakh is purchased on 2019-20. So there will be exemption under section 54. Less exemption under section 54. How much exemption will be there? 54, full amount will be. Why? Because total our new purchase of asset is rupees 8 lakh. Is it 8 lakh? 8 lakh. New purchase of asset is 8 lakh. Our capital gain 1,44,730. Yes. Then the cost of new asset is more than the capital gain. In that case, if it is more than or equal, then full amount of capital gain should be allowed as exemption under section 54. So full amount will be exempted. That is 1,44,730 will be exempted, and it long term capital gain will be nil after exemption. Now you go to the another house property, another property. Now another property is agricultural land in Guwahati. Agricultural land in Guwahati means it is urban agricultural land. On transfer of urban agricultural land, any capital gain arise, this capital gain should be taken as long-term capital gain. Yes, if it fulfills the time period which is mentioned for becoming the long term. This agricultural, urban agricultural land is long term capital asset, so it is transferred. So now you bring this one, urban agricultural land in Guwahati, we write agricultural land, agricultural land in Guwahati. Yes, how much it is? Sale price? Sale price is 3,20,000. Yes, 3,20,000. And index cost of acquisition less index cost of acquisition. What was the cost price of purchase of land? This agricultural land was purchased before 2001 and 2. That means before 1/4/2001. That means it is purchased on 1999 and 2000. In that case, we have to think whether the cost price of the asset or fair market price of the asset on 1/4/2001, whichever is higher, should be taken as value of the cost of the value of the asset for indexing purpose. Yes, let's index cost of one. Here we have to take which is more. 50,000 was cost price, and fair market value on 1/4/2001 was 85,000. Then 85,000 is to be taken into consideration. 85,000. Yes, 85,000 into was the inflation index on 1/4/2001? How much it is? 100. Cost inflation index on date of sale, how much it is? 289. You determine it how much. And it will be amount just 2,45,650. 2,45,650. Yes, you minus it. And capital gain will be, yes, 74,350. Yes, now you bring another asset which is purchased, yes, and which is also a long term capital asset, which is called a soap. Then the asset is soap sale price. How much soap sale price? 2 lakh. Yes, 2 lakh. And less cost of acquisition. What was the cost? So 56,000 into cost inflation index on purchase, it was 129. Yes, 129. And cost inflation index at the date of sale, 289. Yes, and you determine it. How much it will be? 125,457. You minus it and determine the long term capital gain. 74,543. Yes, we get capital gain from these two, agricultural land and soap. We get long term capital gain of 74,350 and 74,543. Now we can go for the exemption under section 54F. What is in the 54F? In the 54F, if any asset purchase, if any capital gain arising from sale of any other asset except house property, then this capital gain can be exempted on the basis of net consideration for purchase of another new residential house property within the stipulated time. That means 1 year before, 2 years after, in case of construction, 3 years. Yes, then are you making total how much? Total is 1,48,893. It is long term capital gain. Yes. Now we go to the exemption under section 54F. Now I bring this one to top and I erase this. You continue with this capital gain. I will bring this one to the top. Yes, for my smooth writing. You continue. Yes, short term is 29,600 short term, and in case of long term capital gain, after all, we continue it. Long term capital gain. Gain how much? It is 1,48,893. You continue with this just for smooth writing. I bring it to the top. Yes, now you go to the exemption under section 54F. Less exemption under section 54F. Yes, 54F. What is in the, I have already told you what is in the section 54F. Just I write down full amount will be exempted. Why it will be exempted, I will give you later on. Full amount of long term capital gain on sale of agricultural land and so, yes, is and so is exempted. Why it is exempted? I will tell you later. 148,893. That means, yes, long term capital gain is nil. Yes, so why this? I am writing here because amount invested on, yes, why we full amount of capital gain received from agricultural land and soap exempted under section 54, I am explaining here. Just add amount invested on new asset is greater than the net consideration of agricultural land and soap. Yes, for that purpose, the full amount of exemption of sale of agricultural land and soap is taken into consideration. Yes, cut. Yes, why? Because as amount invested in new asset, how much? Amount invested, total investment on new asset, 8 lakh, is it? And we use 1,44,730 for exemption from sale of residential house property. Yes, and amount available for exemption under section 54F. How much it is? New investment fund which are available from the capital gain received from sale of agricultural land and so far, 6,55,217. Yes, and net consideration here in case of 54F, we have to consider net consideration of the asset sold where capital gain we received. Then these assets sold where other assets are? Agricultural land and so net consideration of agricultural land and soap, how much we make it total because both are other assets. 3,20,000. You look to the answer where agricultural land sale price 3,20,000. No sale expenses is there, it is the sale consideration. In case of soap, it is 2 lakh. No sale, no expenses, sale, net consideration 2 lakh, net consideration of both is equal to how much? 5,20,000 is the net consideration. If cost of asset, that I have given already on discussion of section 54F, cost of new asset, cost of new asset is more than or equal to net consideration. Yes, then the full value of capital gain arising from that asset should be exempted. If it is net consideration is more, it is less, then we have to calculate a portion will be deducted. Yes? So with this, in this question number one, I will go to the question number two. Yes, question number two, you look to the question number two. Mr. Ahoy owns two houses at Amritsar and Lucknow. He transferred following long-term capital asset during 2019-20. So I have given particulars and assets. There are three types of assets which he was sold. Yes, assets are residential house at Lucknow, gold and silver. And date of sale. Residential house 17-4-2019 and gold 18-4-2019, silver 19-4-2019. Sale consideration 9 lakh, 7 lakh, 5 lakh. Index cost of acquisition, we no need to determine the cost of acquisition, index cost of acquisition, because it is given as index cost of acquisition. 3 lakh, 6 lakh, 2 lakh, 75,000. And Abhar passes the following assets. He also passes assets. Residential house in Delhi on October 22, 2019, 7 lakh 50, and bond of National Highway Authority of India and SAI for the purpose of section 54 EC, October 19, 2019, 2 lakh assigned in his capital gain, which is chargeable for income tax under six, for the assessment year 2020-21. Yes? Now we solve this problem. Solution problem 2 solution. Yes, problem 2 solution. Now we go to the solution of the problem. Yes, here also write down computation of capital gain. Computation of capital gain of Mr. Ahoy, yes, for the previous year, you can write for the previous year, yes, 2019-20, if you write the previous year, if you write the assessment year, then 2020-21, and here also you made 3 column for 3 assets. Yes, 3 column for 3 assets. Assets, there are 3 assets. 1, 2, 3. And here write particulars and here residential house. Residential house. Yes, and gold and there is silver. These three assets. So here particulars. Yes. Here we write the particulars and asset, residential house, gold and silver. Here we write rupees, rupees, rupees in these three columns. Yes. And you bring sale consideration for all our long-term capital asset because they cross the long-term time period. So we have to treat all this long-term. So sale consideration, residential house property 9 lakh. Yes, and 7 lakh gold. And silver 5 lakh. And next, less index cost. No need to determine the index cost because it is given as index cost. Less index cost of acquisition. Yes, index cost of acquisition. How much? 3 lakh, 6 lakh. 3 lakhs, 6 lakhs. and another is 2,25,000. And determine the long-term capital gain. Long-term capital gain 6 lakhs, 1 lakh, 6 lakhs, 1 lakh. So it is 75, not 2,75,000, and 2,25,000. Yes, 2,25,000. Now it is called as long term capital gain. We determine long term capital gain 6 lakhs, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 25% of 3 different assets and exemptions. Less exemption. Exemptions first under section 54, because we have purchased another asset of new residential house is purchased for rupees 6 lakhs. Yes, how much it is? New residential house value is, total residential value is 7,50,000. 7,50,000. Now, whether we can use this for exemption for capital gain which is arising from sale of residential house? Yes, we can use exemptions. First one is under section 54. How much you can use? Cost of new asset is 7,50,000. 7,50,000. And we gain from residential house property 6 lakhs. Then we can use up to 6 lakhs. It is because new asset cost is more than the capital gain. So it is exemption under 64. Under 54, it is 6 lakhs. Yes? 6 lakhs. Then, after 6 lakh exemption, what will be the available remaining balance? 2,50,000. Sorry, 1,50,000. I am telling you this one because it will be required for later on. And 6 lakhs exemption we get under section 54. And capital gain from this one is nil. Yes, right, later on nil. So you just see this capital gain become nil. Next, under section 54, less under section, yes, under section 54 EC. Yes, 54 EC, capital gain of gold. How much this gold we receive? 1 lakh. From silver we receive 2,25,000. What was the amount available for us for investment into the, as it is given here, bonds of National Highway Authority of India for the purpose of section 54, it is 2 lakh. That means we can use 2 lakh. 2 lakh, yes, 2 lakh NS AI bonds. Yes, we can use under section 54 EC, yes, on bond of National Highway Authority of India. So, first we can use this 1 lakh, total amount is 1 lakh, 2 lakh, yes, 1 lakh. We can use from gold. Yes, 1 lakh gold. What will be available? After 1 lakh using, 1 lakh will be available. Next 1 lakh can be used for silver. Yes, next 1 lakh can be used for silver. So you can write here capital gain of gold. Capital gain, capital gain of gold rupees 1 lakh, yes, rupees 1 lakh invested in bonds of N H A I. So I write here, this is 1 lakh. Yes, 1 lakh. Next, capital gain of silver, rupees 1 lakh. I have explained you 1 lakh. Yes, invested in bonds of NHAI. That means it is 1 lakh. Yes, 1 lakh. So now we determine the capital gain. What we now position? Now position is, it is nil. It is nil. Just it is 1,25,000 available here. 1,25,000 available. But now you go to the Section 54A. Whether we can apply the exemption of Section 54A? No. These two assets have already cleared their capital gain. They got full exemption. And amount available for 54F only this silver. So if other assets are there, we will allow this 54 for silver or for other assets also. Now only you can allow for silver because other assets are already fully exempted. Yes, next you go to the section under section 54. Under section 54F. It is cost of investment in new asset into, yes, long term capital gain divided by net consideration. Yes. Now we have to go through this formula. Why? You look how much amount available for new investment. New investment amount was 7,50,000. Yes, already 6 lakhs used for 54. Yes, section 54. What is available? 1,50,000 is available. 1,50,000 is only available. Then you go to the net consideration of silver because you are going to get exemption on silver. Here we have to consider net consideration. Cost of new asset is for this exemption available is 1,50,000 and net consideration is 2,25,000. The cost of acquisition of new asset is less than the net consideration. So, in that case, we cannot give the full amount exemption. We have to go to this formula, consider cost of investment in new asset into long term capital gain, that is, and divided by net consideration, that is. Yes? Now you put the amount here. I think you understand. It is 1 lakh. It is 1,50,000. 1 lakh into net capital gain 1,25,000. Net consideration 2,25,000. Yes, you determine how much it will be. It will be 67,500. It will be 67,500. The exemption will be 67,500. This exemption, 67,500. This exemption exemption under section 54 can be claimed by other asset also. Except residential gold can also claim this exemption, but gold has no any amount available from capital gain for getting exemption. So only we allow to silver. Yes. So make it deduction 57,500. Yes, it is long term capital gain. I think you understand this one. It is the long term capital gain. With this, it is the completion of question number 2. Now you come to question number 3. I will give you different types of questions for treatment of capital gain, so you can understand and this will be help for your examination. So question is, Mr. Amarpreet submits the following particulars of the sale of his assets during the year 2019-20, and particulars, there are 3 assets. One is jewelry, another is plot, next is one is gold. Yes, plot means plot of land. And sale price of jewelry 6 lakhs, plot 22,48,000, gold 33,60,000. Expenses on sale, jewelry nil, plot 48,000, gold nil. Cost of acquisition 2,50,000. Yes, 8 lakh. 1,60,000. Year of acquisition 2009-10 in case of jewelry, plot 2006-07 and gold 2011-12. Cost of a cost inflation index, jewelry 148, plot 122, gold 184. He purchased a residential house for 14 lakhs. Yes. On 4-3-2020, calculate the amount of capital gain. Of if cost inflation index for 2019-20 289, that means we by analyzing this problem we find that all assets are long term capital assets, and on transfer of these assets or sale of this asset we will get only long term capital gain. Now we solve this one. Yes, computation of it is question number 1 solution. Computation of capital gain, or you can write taxable capital gain of Mr. Harpreet. Yes, it is not 1-3, just question number 3. I completed 1 and 2, now it is question number 3 solution. Yes, and of Harpreet for the previous year, previous year 2019-20. Now again you make the column for 3 assets, makes 3 columns. Yes, for 3 assets you make 3 columns. Assets are, one is jewelry, another is plot, plot means plot of land, plot. And next one is gold. Yes, here particulars. Yes, here all rupees. Thus, these 3. And sale, we bring sale price of all assets. First, sale price. How much? Sale price. 6 lakhs, first one jewelry 6 lakhs, and plot 22 lakhs 48,000 and goal 3,60,000. Yes, less expenses on sale. Expenses on sale, it is nil. Here 48,000, here nil, and deduct it, save 6 lakhs. It is 6 lakhs. 6 lakhs, 22 lakh, 48,000. Sorry, 22 lakhs, 48,000 deducted, 22 lakhs, and 3,60,000. It is net consideration. Net consideration. Is it? It is net consideration. Now you get the net consideration. Now you deduct the less index cost of acquisition. Less indexed cost of acquisition. How much index cost of it is mentioned in case of jewelry? Jewelry, how much cost price? 2,50,000. 2,50,000 into index and on date of purchase. Yes, now jewelry, what was the cost price? 2,50,000 into index at the date of inflation index at the date of purchase 148, inflation index at the date of sale 289, plot 8 lakh, it is cost inflation index on date of purchase 122, date of sale 289, goal 160, cost inflation index on date of purchase 184, on date of sale 289, then you determine the amount. How much amount will be? For jewelry, 4,88,170. 4,88,170. Yes? And again, plot, you write plot. Plot is how much? 18,95,082. 18,95,082. And in case of gold, how much gold? Gold amount is 2,51,304. 2,51,304. So these are cost of acquisition. Deduct this one, this all. And we get the capital gain, long term capital gain. Long term capital gain, how much? 111,824. And next 304,918. You made the calculation, but I done all this calculation for our time saving. And 108,696. These are our long term capital gain. Now you come to do deduction under section 54 F, because there is no 54 deduction. 54 deduction only for any capital gain arising from sale of essential house property. We are not selling any essential house property. And next, 54 EC does not come. Yes, because no investment in NSAR. So now only exemption will be here. Will be for deduction under section 54 F, less deduction under section 54 F, because we invested how much? 14 lakhs in a purchase of new residential house. Yes, in purchase of residential 14 lakhs we invested on 4/3/2020 in this previous year. So now you get the exemption. Now, here you always look when this type of problem will arise, then total amount is how much? 14 lakhs. Is it 14 lakhs total amount we have to spend in case of passage of new SF? We have already spent, thus we have to get the exemption. Now, there in all three HHs shows the capital gain. First, we have to determine which capital gain is, percentage of capital gain is more. For the SSE, it will be beneficial if asset which provides more capital gain will be exempted first. Then it will be beneficial for the SSE. In that case, we have to determine the percentage of long-term capital gain to net consideration of deferred items. So, here, the deduction percentage of long-term capital gain, capital gain to net consideration. Here, jewelry, another one is plot, plot and gold. We determine it separately. How we can determine? Because here, working note, you put the working note. Working note 1. Working note 1, you write percentage of long-term capital gain to net consideration. Of long-term capital gain to net consideration. Then we have to determine how much jewelry, how much capital gain? 111824. Net consideration in case of jewelry, how much? 6 lakhs. And into 100, you get the percentage. And in case of plot, capital gain, how much? 3 lakh 4,918 divided by net consideration 22 lakhs. Into 100. And next one is gold. Gold, how much capital gain? 108,696 divided by net consideration 3,60,000 into 100. How much it will be? First one is 19%, next one is 14%, next one is 30%. You will put here jewelry, how much? 19%. It is working note. Just net consider it is 1. You put here 1. Just working note, you will see the working note. 19%, 14%, and 30%. That means what? That means we have to use, this is the capital gain portion is more in case of gold, next in case of jewelry, next in case of plot. Now we have to use first these 14 lakhs which has to be invest. Then first we have to use gold, next jewelry, third plot. On the basis of that, this will be beneficial for the SSE. So I think you continue. You write it on the footnote as working note. Another working note we have to prepare here. Another working note. Working note 2. Working note 2. That means how much working note 2. Here in working note 2, total investment on the new asset was how much? Rupees 14 lakhs. Yes, in rupees 14 lakhs. So, how much amount of this 14 lakhs to be used for gold, cloth and jewelry? Because this 14 lakhs cannot be equal with the net consideration of these three assets. So, we have to determine it. The assets invested, you write down the SSE invested in the working note, you write down invested in the net consideration, in the net consideration, in the net consideration of new purchase of new purchase of, yes, new purchase of long-term capital asset, long-term capital asset, long-term capital asset, yes, of house property rupees, how much? 14 lakh, yes, how it is invested? For, as I have told you, that we have to prefer gold first. Yes, for gold, out of 14 lakhs, total 3,60,000 we have to allow. Gold amount, first gold, 3,60,000. Yes, it is, and it is percentage is more. Next, we have to use jewelry. Next percentage is jewelry. Jewelry, second jewelry. Jewelry net consideration how much? 6 lakhs. 6 lakhs. So, finally, final, what is that? Last one is plot. Final plot. The plot, how much amount will get by plot? Because we have already used 9,60,000, 3,60,000 plus 6 lakhs. Out of 14 lakhs, 9,60,000 already used for gold and jewelry. How much amount will be available? It will be 4 lakh. Yes? Now it is 4,40,000. 4,40,000 will be available for plot. This 4,40,000, you put the rupees here and rupees. 4,40,000 available for the plot. Now this is the working note 2. Yeah, you write down this working note. And will you continue the, yes, goal? I have given you the percentage. Just I put all these things to the top because it will be easy for me to write down. One point I left. It is beneficial. It is yes. It is beneficial to the SSE, yes, to the SSE, yes, it is beneficial to SSE to claim, yes, I have written here, it is beneficial to the SSE, just I have told you, just I written it, it is beneficial to the SSE to claim exemption under section 54F, first from gold, because gold percentage is capital gain percentage is more. Next from jewelry, yes. Next jewelry and finally from plot. Now we determine the amount of, okay, here how much plot in case of first you gold, I write in the top, you continue it, gold, you write here, gold, I write, you continue with the gold, how much it was, cost of acquisition, investment on gold, we determine in the working note 2, rupees 6 lakh. Yes, and net consideration 6 lakhs. That means if it is a cost of acquisition is more than the net consideration or equal to the net consideration, then full amount will be exempted. 111824. Yes. Next, you go to the jewelry investment was how much? 3 lakh 60. Investment in a working note 2. You give it in the working note 2. Investment on jewelry rupees 3 lakh 60 thousand and net consideration rupees 3 lakh 60 thousand. That means full amount will be exempted because it is equal. 10496. Yes, now you come to the next, third one is plot. Yes, plot investment as per new working note 2, we have mentioned investment on plot. Yes, how much? Rupees 4,40,000 remaining part and net consideration on plot. Net consideration, plot I have written earlier. Net consideration how much? 22 lakhs. Net consideration rupees 22 lakhs. Here cost of new asset is less than the net consideration. Then you put the formula. Formula is cost of acquisition 4,40,000 into capital gain on that asset 3,04,918 and net consideration 22 lakhs. How much it will be? It will be 60,984. This amount will be only exempted. 60,984. Yes. The long term capital gain, it is nil. Here also nil. Here it will be 2,83,934. 2,83,934. It is the long-term capital gain. Long-term capital gain. Or you can write taxable. It is taxable capital gain. Yes? So, this way we solve this problem. I think you continue this one. As I have left, I bring it to the top for smooth writing. So with this, I have solved these three questions for you. I think if you go through these three types of questions, it will be beneficial for you for the examination purpose. So with this, I end my chapter capital gain. Thank you. Thank you very much.